Pronation therapy, or prone positioning, is a short-term therapeutic modality used to improve oxygenation in patients with acute respiratory distress syndrome, ARDS. It involves turning the patients into the abdomen in the face down. ARDS is not a diffuse, homogeneous disease that affects all areas of the lungs equally. Instead, the dependent lung areas are more heavily damaged than the non-dependent lung areas. Pronation therapy improves perfusion to less damaged areas of the lungs and improve ventilation-perfusion matching. Some studies shows that patients with self-proning with high-flow nasal cannula improve oxygenation in COVID-19 pneumonia. Early application of prolonged pronation sessions decrease day mortality. The pronation may be used up to 20 hours per day. If the patient awakes, he or she can do it independently or with support from the nurse or the respiratory therapist. A number of methods are discussed in the literature, including manually turning the patient with the use of a single sheet, turning system or turning frame, and turning the patient's use of the rotoprone therapy system. In our ICU, we will practice manually turning for vented patients using jelly roll method. Complications of the procedure include dislodgement or obstruction of the tubes and drains, cardiac arrhythmias, hemodynamic instability, massive facial edema, pressure injuries, aspiration, or corneal ulcerations. The team will have one respiratory therapist, four nurses, and one physician standby if the patient extubated accidentally. The supplies which we will need: two flat sheets, three gel pads or pillows. The team has to have like plan, assigning the rules, anticipate the complications which might happen, like dislodgements or like cardiac arrhythmias, assess the patient's hemodynamic status to determine he or she is able to tolerate positioning change, administer sedatives, analgesics as prescribed, perform eye care, including lubricating the eyes and horizontal tapping of the closed eyelids. Ensure that the patient's tongue was inside his or her mouth. If the tongue was swollen or protruding, insert a bite block or oropharyngeal airway. If available, apply a protective barriers, hydrocolloid or foam dressings to the face and the all bony prominence like shoulders, chest, iliac crest, elbows, TPL areas as needed. Reposition all lines, tubes, drains that were located above the patient's waist up toward the head of the bed. Reposition all lines, tubes and drains that were located below the waist down toward the foot of the bed. Change dressings that were due to be changed during the pronation therapy. Stop enteral feeding. Suction the patient's artificial airway and oral cavity. Maybe the respiratory therapist will administer 100% oxygenation. Place long gel pads on the patient. Use pillow if gel pad were not available. Place the pillow across the patient's chest above the level of the axilla. Remove the ECG electrodes from the patient's chest. Place the pillow across the patient's iliac crest. Don't place the pillow below the iliac crest as femoral nerve compression could occur. Place the pillow in the chins. Prepare the patient to turn. You can turn the patient's head so it will face away from the direction of the turn. Loop the ventilator tube above the patient's head. Place the patient's arms alongside of the body with the fingers positioning toward the feet beneath the patient's buttocks. Cover the patient with a sheet. Fold down the top of the sheet to expose the patient's head. Along both sides of the patient, grab the top and the bottom sheets together and tightly roll them up to the sides of the patient, sandwiching the patient firmly between the sheets. Slide the patient to the side of the bed opposite to the ventilator. On a three count, roll the patient over into the prone position, tightly holding the rolled up sheet on each side of the patient. You can do this one on two steps, like lateral then prone. Then unfold the flat sheet that was under the patient's head, pull and centers the patient in the bed. Correctly positions all the tubes, drains, lines, attach the ECG electrodes in the patient's back. Rotate the patient's arms parallel to the body and then place them in a position of comfort. Place pillows under the patient's chins to raise the patient's ankle off the bed and maintain the patient's feet in dorsiflexed position. Align patient's face on foam pillow to ensure that there is no pressure on the eyes. adjust the bed to place a patient in reverse trundling bed position. This also may facilitate gastric emptying as well as minimizing facial and ocular edema. Resume the tube feeding. Assess patient's hemodynamic and oxygenation status after placing him or her in the prone position. With a manual positioning, reposition the patient's head while he or she is in prone position to prevent facial skin breakdown. Provide frequent oral care and suction the airway as needed. Maintain tube feeding as tolerated. Now turning the patient from the prone position to supine position using the manual technique. We need to prepare the patient to the turn, loop the ventilator tube above the patient's head, place patient's arm along sides of the body with the fingers positioning toward the feet. Remove the ECG electrodes from the patient's back. Along both sides of the patients, grab the top and the bottom sheet together and tightly roll them up to the side of the patient, sandwiching the patients firmly between the sheets. Slide the patient to the side of the bed opposite of the side you will turn him. On a three count, roll the patient over into the supine position, tightly holding the rolled up sheets on each side of the patient. Pull and center the patients in the bed. Correctly position all the tubes, drains and the lines and the ECG electrodes on the patient's chest. Place patient's arm in position of comfort. Adjust the bed to place the patient in semi-parallel position. And you can resume the feeding. Thank you so much.